Good morning and happy Sabbath to all of the members of Coushatta's First Seventh-day Adventist Church Memorial and Cedar Grove. It is my privilege to stand before you this morning, and I thank you for allowing me in your home to worship with you today. And our scripture shall be found in Psalms 91. Just before that, we'll pause for a brief word of prayer. Father, we come once again. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for what you will continue to do in our life. We ask now, Father, that you bless us all, that we might hear a word from you this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Once again, that is Psalms, the 91 division, verse 1 and 3. He that dwelleth in the secret places of the Most High shall abide in the shadows of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver me from the north, from the snares of the fowler, and from the northern pestilence. We live in a time that everything appears out of control, and we are, as individuals, just kind of anxious about everything. Things appear that they're not certain. But one thing we can count on, the certainty of God. He says that He'll never leave us nor forsake us at any time. We just have to trust in Him. So I stopped in your home this morning to bring you a word. And the title of the day is, He shall deliver you. He shall deliver you. Don't matter what's going on in the world or society, God shall deliver you. I was just listening to CNN the other day. The president said that this pandemic is going to get worse and worse as we go forth. And many lives may be lost. But you, God's child, you, the children of God, He will deliver you, just as He delivered Daniel out of the lion's den. He would deliver you. So why should we worry when He said He is our refuge? And a refuge means a place that we can go to and feel safe, comforted, and sheltered, and has everything that we need or desire, a safe place, if you will. God is our safe place, and in Him, we can trust. We can trust Him with our very life. We can trust Him with our families. We can trust Him in any situation. Rain, shine, sleet, or snow, we can still trust in God, no matter what. And He says He will never leave us, nor will He ever forsake us. He will be there when we need it the most. And the Bible says that He's a very present help in the time of our sorrow. God will be with us. In the midst of the storm, He's going to be with us. He's not going to forsake us. He's going to be right there. Just remember, he shall deliver you. He will deliver you. So therefore, since he will deliver us, we can trust in him whatever he says. We can trust it. It's not like the stock market. It's up today, down tomorrow. It's up, down, and going sideways sometimes. It's uncertainty, but with God, he's certain all the time. He will be right there with us whenever we need him. We just got to trust him. We just got to have the faith of a little baby. We just got to have the faith of a child and just come to him and just pour out our life desires to him, because he is able to keep us from falling. He's able. And the pestilence, I know that's on our minds. It's all over the media, it's everywhere. We can't turn for it. Those pestilence. Well, here's the good news. Pestilence is defined as pandemic. But guess what? Jesus is God of all. He can take care of you through any situation. He can. So how do we know? This is not going to be the last pandemic we probably go through. It certainly has not been the first. If we would just travel back in our own minds back to the biblical days when the children of Israel was in captivity and Pharaoh passed the decree that all the firstborn will die. But God people, they got a word from God. There was a prophet that he got a word from and said that you just put the blood over the doorpost. If you put the blood over the doorpost, your child would not die. Although we know the death angel did go out and did destroy, but none of the children of Israel, they all were saved. So if he did that back then, he still worked miracles in 2020. He's a miracle-working God, and he will continue to make miracles in our lives on a daily basis, but we just have to trust in him. You know, sometimes that's a hard thing to do for some of us sometimes, because we kind of like to do it our own way. We don't like rules and regulations. We don't like someone telling us what to do. But God says that he will guide us through the processes of our life if we just let him. If we just let him. And he said he's standing at the door and knock. And if we was to only open the door, he would come in. He's not going to barge his way in. He's not going to break in. He needs our permission to come in and help. He wants to help us. He's standing ready to help us. He knows exactly what we need. And he has the power to deliver that which we need. So, I will trust in God always. Don't matter how dire the situation look in life, God will take care of you. Don't matter how dire your bank account looks, God will provide a ram. Don't matter. Whatever you're going through right now, God got you. Whatever you're going to go through tomorrow, God got you. Whatever you have been through, you already know that he's able and has helped you thus far. You're still here, that he's able to take care of you. So I say to you today, as we look around and look at the things that are happening, don't worry about the things that's happening. Don't be fearful of what's going on, because God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of sound mind. So God, he's going to take care of you. He's promised that. So trust in God. Lean not into your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. And surely, when your time of trouble shall come, God will raise up a standard against the enemy, because the scripture said, God will deliver you. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for your guidance. We thank you for your power, your strength. We know that you'll be here for us when we need you the most. Help us to commit our ways unto you and lean not to our own understanding, and keep us and through this difficult time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Happy Sabbath, church family. Cedar Grove Memorial and Coushatta First. I would like to ask and remind you of some ways you can give your tithe and offering during this time of social distancing. We would like to ask you to go on AdventistGiving.org. That's AdventistGiving.org. Put in your church name. So for Cedar Grove members, you could put in Cedar Grove Seventh-day Adventist Church. For Memorial members, you could put in Memorial Seventh-day Adventist Church. And for members of Coushatta First, you can go online and put Coushatta First Seventh-day Adventist Church. And it will look just like your tithe envelope, just the electronical version. You can also, if you have a cell phone, look it up and download the app. And you'll also be able to put your information in, as once again, it'll look just like your tithe envelope, and it'll have all the line items that you can give to. We are encouraging to give to church budget and tithe. Also, for individuals who do not have access to internet or do not have access to the app, we do want to ask if you would let us know, that us as in the clerk and the pastor, and first elder, let us know so that we can have an individual, a signed individual, come to your house and pick up your tithe and offering, because we do not want to hinder you being faithful to God during this season. It is important, and I want to stress the importance of this, because during this crisis, we are dealing with a lot of workers in trouble. I'll say it like that, because as you know, we are a world church. And we have ministers throughout the whole world who are carrying this gospel, as well as missionaries and teachers. So the tithe is to further the gospel ministry throughout the world. And if we do not give our tithe, if we are not faithful to God, we are putting the spreading of God's word at risk. Also our offering. There are members in our churches who may be experiencing being laid off. There are bills that we still have to pay. And it is important that we be faithful, because we want to be able to help our local community. There might be members that we might need to help, as well as in order to keep the church abreast and moving forward, we want to make sure that we are faithful so that we can take care of our business, so that God can take care of his business. So I want to implore you to please give during this time of being not physically together at AdventistGiving.org. God bless you.